العلوم غصون وشجون يدخل بعضها في بعض، الحكايات بعضها يدخلك في بعض آخر. العلوم غصون شجون كما يقول العلماء، بعضها تدخل في بعض، كما أن الغصون بعضها يدخل تحت بعض، كذلك مواد العلم كذلك إذا يستحضرها الإنسان يأتي بعضها من وراء بعض ويدخل تحت. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد حضر مائدة لعبد الله بن شبعان، حكاية عجيبة، وحضرها أبو جهل، فرعون الأمة، فرعون الأمة كلها، فرعون فرعون مصر وفرعون الأمة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم محمدية، فرعونها أبو جهل، فرعون الأمة النبي عرف بجحشه ركبته إذا اختفى بين الهوالك، وكلم النبي جثثهم وبخلق الخشب كما قال سيدي أحمد البدوي في الغزوات عن السير. المهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حضر هذه المائدة في يوم من الأيام، وكان هناك أبو جهل فتصارعنا عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وصرعه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أعطي قوة 40 رجلا أو 1000 رجلا على اختلاف، يعني كثير من الرجال، يعني أعطي قوة لم يعطها غيره. صرعه وانشج في ركبته وصار ذلك أثرا. فلما كان يوم بدر والتقى المسلمون مع كفار قريش في وقعة بدر، تلاقى الجيشان هنالك واقتتلوا، وقتل من المشركين ما عدد كثير، وأسر 70، وكانت الغلبة على المشركين، وصاروا يبحثون عن أبي جهل، صار المسلمون يبحثون عن أبي جهل لأنه هو العدو الوحيد، وإذا تحققوا أنه مات فعرفوا أن الكفر مات جزء كبير منه. فقالوا كيف نعرف أبا جهل ونحن لا نعرف، هذا كثير من الأنصار لم يقدموا مكة، وهؤلاء ناس آخرون ولا نعرف القتلى كثيرة ولا نعرف. قال لهم ابحثوا عن ركبته ففيها شجة قد شجيته بها عند مائدة عبد الله بن جدعان. هكذا صار عبد الله بن جدعان يتلى في أمرك، وصار يتلى في يوم بدر، وصار يتلى في كل موقع لجوده. فالبخل رأس المشاكل والجود رأس المال.
قبل البعث أو
قبلها حضرها
So he said the story of Abdullah Jud'an, the Prophet taking part in his banquet. And before that, he mentioned, he said, knowledge and is like the tree, is like the limbs of a tree. Just like the limbs of a tree don't all grow straight and they don't interconnect. If you look at a tree, a lot of its limbs are interconnected and the branches are interconnected. So the same thing with, if you open up one chapter of knowledge, of ilm, you're going to see how it connects, it's interconnected to all of the other branches. So here we're talking about Abdullah ibn Jud'an, and now it's interconnected with another story where the Prophet ﷺ and in Badr as well. So he said that before the Prophet ﷺ being sent as a prophet during his early years, he was at the banquet of Abdullah ibn Jud'an and he was taking part in it. And Abu Jahl was there as well. This is, of course, before he was Abu Jahl, but who would later become Abu Jahl. He said that, and Abu Jahl is the Fir'aun of this ummah, is the Fir'aun of this nation. Just like in Egypt, with the Bani Israel, they had their Fir'aun, and we all know the stories of, it's the most often repeated story in the Quran. We are very familiar with the story, the character of Fir'aun. The Fir'aun of this ummah, in his treatment of the believers, is Abu Jahl. He said that the Prophet ﷺ was at the banquet of Abdullah ibn Jud'an, and Abu Jahl was there, and they wrestled. And the Prophet ﷺ, as is mentioned in the hadith, had the strength of 40 men, or some hadith say 1,000 men. So nobody could beat him. So he wrestled Abu Jahl, and in the process of the wrestling and throwing him down, Abu Jahl cut open his knee, and he had a wound there that would last, that would be a mark people would know him by for the rest of his life. Years later, of course, after the Prophet ﷺ being sent and making hijrah to Medina, and then the Battle of Badr, the Muslims were given victory. A large number of the mushrikeen were killed. 70 were taken hostage. And then when they were looking at the dead, they wanted to make sure that Abu Jahl was dead. And because if they were sure that through this battle Abu Jahl was killed, then a huge portion of kufr, a huge portion of the force of kufr would have been eliminated. So a lot of the Sahaba there that day were Ansar. They had never been to Mecca. They never saw Abu Jahl before that. They didn't know how to recognize him. And there were other people there as well that had never seen him face. So they didn't know him by face. They just know him by stories. So what was described, the Prophet ﷺ said, look for him, you'll find him, he'll have a wound on his knee. I gave him that wound after wrestling him when I was at the banquet of Abdullah ibn Jud'an. So he said, look at Abdullah ibn Jud'an, because of his generosity, he was mentioned by the Prophet ﷺ at Badr. His story is now forever locked in the books of knowledge. Here we are in America mentioning the story of Abdullah ibn Jud'an because of his generosity over 1,000 years ago.
فقال الله وإياكم لما يحبه ويرضاه ارتقبوا أعمال الآخرة في هذه العشر الأواخر. سنتكلم إن شاء الله في يوم السبت الآتي حدود هذا الوقت السادسة تقريبا أو الخامسة والنصف إن شاء الله, يعني الخامسة والنصف. ولا تتخلفوا كما تخلفتم في الدرس الماضي. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لباب واحد يتعلمه الرجل أحب إلي من 1000 ركعة تطوعا, حديث ابن ماجه. فالعلم أفضل العبادات وأقربها إلى الله تعالى. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي.
So he said, inshallah, may Allah give us a new tawfiq. Next week we'll have a dars. We'll go back to the regular schedule of Saturday, and we'll do it. We'll have it at 5:30 to 6:30. He said next week's lesson, again, this series of lectures is about doing good in general and giving sadaqah and the other types of good. Next week's focus will be on Laylatul Qadr and the benefits of Laylatul Qadr and what is Laylatul Qadr. And he said he wants everybody to make sure to be there and to not miss it, and realize that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that one chapter or one subject that a person learns from sacred knowledge is more beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam than 1,000 rak'ahs of extra prayer. So aside from the and this is a, he said as long as a person knows the rules of prayer, because somebody might not even, he's talking about 1,000 rak'ahs from a person that knows the rules of prayer. There's some people that are praying and they don't know the rules of prayer.
SubhanAllah.